Hey guys, Pennadaily here, and welcome back to Let's Play Little Magic. In the last episode, we started the game, and that's really it. We learned a lot of the mechanics, so now we are in the Trial Tower, where things start getting a bit interesting. That was dumb. You'll see why I made that mistake here shortly. Alright, just go. Okay, so the gate's unlocked. Now, these portals, you want to walk across these tiles this way, and then this way, and then we're out. Yeah. The Trial Tower is also where enemies start being a thing, as you can see here. Okay, this is a bit of a thing. Okay, first you start coming this way. Now, remember, the magic ball will block enemies. But you cannot put it on them, so keep that in mind. Okay. And you cannot kick it into them, so yeah. Okay, move this way, come here. Now we want to be here. Wait till this snake passes you going the other way. Good, that'll block him. Come this way. We're going to push this down, and we're actually going to push it down one more, and then come across here like this, wait for the snake to move. If you know what you're doing, it's not that hard. Do not push this any farther, because you're going to have to do this. I think we only need to put it there as two. Probably could have done it with just one. Sorry if I still sound a little froggy. There we go. Yeah. Alright. So that's that. I've decided instead we're gonna do, yeah, basically you can do nothing except... There. The magic ball will block enemies, but you can't kill them or anything like that. The Trial Tower is kind of an interesting, very pseudo-Egyptian thing. Okay, so first, we come here. Good. And now this one's a bit interesting. There we go. Alright. There. There. Don't push it down farther. Now we want to kick it. Push it. Let's see, one, kick it, good. Now we want to, one, two, kick, one, two, three. Probably could have just done it single, but now here's where it starts getting to be a thing. Okay, this is one, two, kick, one, two, three, one, two, three, kick, one, two, three. Okay, so one, two, three. Ugh. Yeah, okay, let's try this again. One, two, kick. One, two, three, push. One, kick. There. Now we get to get it out there. So, one, two, three, kick. One, two, three, push. One, kick. One, two, kick. One, two, three, push. Oh, that was dumb. Okay, let's try this again. Wait till that... Okay, so it's... One, two, three, kick. One, two, three, push. One, kick. One, two, three... Okay, I need to stop doing that. Okay. Yeah, my timing is still not very good, even with this, so... One, two, three, kick. One, two, three, push. One, kick. Okay. One, kick. One, two, three, push. There we go. And now we just walk across here. And... Yay! We have finished... We have finished the Trial Tower. On to Fire Cave 2. Okay, this place is fun. And here you are going to find, you know, the lava. Here we are really going to make use of the lava's expand the fact that the lava works in reverse. Kick, 1, 2, 3, push. Good. Now come across here, kick it, 1, 2, 3, push, 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, kick, 1, 2, 3, push. One kick, 1, 2, 3, push. One kick, 1, 2, 3. That was stupid. Alright. Okay. One kick, 1, 2, 3, push. 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, push. There we go. Oh, dumb. Okay, so now this is a bit more of a thing. So, 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, push. 1, 2, 3, kick. Okay, that didn't work. Okay. So it's 1, kick. 1, 2, 3, push. 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, push. Good. Now, that's going to go... Now that has to shrink all the way down. That's a thing, but, you know, we can wait. So yeah, this place starts really making use of the expansion of the lava mechanic, which is kind of interesting, I think. Okay, this introduces a new mechanic. See those tiles that have some sort of character on them? I don't know what it is. You cannot do bubbles on them, or maybe it's just a no bubble symbol. You can, when standing on them, you cannot make a magic ball. But that's okay. Push it to the end. Don't pop it. Push. 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, push. Well, that really didn't matter. Now come here and kick it down. And then... 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, pop. 1, 2, 3, pop. Kick it down. I don't care if it's magic, it's supposed to be psychic power, it's... you're kicking it. Yeah, those things are gonna be more of a thing, like, here. Okay, so this one. Come up here. Good. Go this way. Come there. Good. Now this is where it's gonna start getting a bit funny. Okay, so there. Now come here. 1, 2, 3, kick. Okay, so... 1, 2, push up. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, kick. Please don't let me have screwed that up. Good. Just barely didn't screw it up. Yeah, this... timing is a little more of a thing here. But we made it. This one gave me a lot of trouble the first time I tried it out. And despite what I said, given how it's going, Forest 2. I believe that in the fan translation, it is called Time Forest 2, or something like that. Okay, so we've got an Octorok. Isn't it cute? I have no idea what it's called, but it's an Octorok. I'm pretty sure there's a Zelda Classic quest that uses this sprite for Octoroks. They push the magic stone. Don't push anything else, by the way. You cannot use them to push bubbles, sadly. Alright, so yeah. I'm going to be doing 3 blocks per episode, just because they really don't take that long. Okay. There we go. Push it this way. Stop, because... there. Push that there. Okay. Kick. Well, I didn't need to do that, but oh well. Now, push it down. And kick it this way. 1, 2, 3, pop. 1, 2, 3, pop. Whoops. 1, 2, 3. Pop. Okay, that worked. Kick it there. Let him push that. Now, he won't push it any farther, but that's okay. I didn't need to do that, but whatever. He won't pop your bubble either, which is good. He just tries to push it and nothing happens. So, yeah. So, yeah, I'm going to do three episodes, or three blocks per episode, and this will be a 5-episode LP. You know, pretty standard like the Lolos. Okay, so we come here, no problem. And we come here, no problem. And we come down. Let's see here. Push this way. Do not step on that yet. Good. There. Wait. Good. Now kick it up, and there we go. Yeah, the forest ones don't seem to be quite as hard in some, but I'm sure that'll change. Okay, so first thing we do, let's trap all the snakes. Just call us St. Patrick. Alright. Wait for it. Wait for it. Ha. Okay, now this is basically just an exercise in how good are you at distance bubbling. 3, 2, 1, kick. Kick, 1, kick, 1, 2, 3, poke. Good. 1, kick, 1, 2, 3, poke. 1, 2, 3, kick. Well, that was dumb. Okay. 1, 2, 3, poke. 1, 2. That just worked, and I'm ridiculously lucky it did. Kick it down. 1, 2, 3, pop. 1, 2, 3, pop. 1, kick. 1, kick. 1, 2, 3, pop. Let's see. Now just push it over to here and up. And now we're doing the same thing, basically. 1. Kick. 1, 2, 3, pop. 1, kick. 1, 2, 3, pop. 1, kick. Okay, now. 1, 2, kick. 1, 2, 3, pop. 1, kick. 1, kick. 1, 2, 3, pop. Well, that worked. Never mind. Yeah, sometimes I don't always realize when it's going to be okay. Kick. And that one's short, so that's nice. And there we go. Yeah, so I'm going to go like 32, 33 levels. So it's roughly 16, 17 levels an episode. Okay. So we got to come across here. Let's see. Push this up. Now let's see. 1, 2, 3, push that. Good. Come here, kick that over. Now, 1, 2, 3, kick. 1. It's gonna be. Right. 1, 2, 3. Pop. Whoops. And just push it along. Yeah, that's not so hard. All right. This one gets a bit interesting. So we come up here. We can come up here. Good. And here. Let's see here. Let's see. There. And now remember that you can walk across these things. You can do that. Now we get to come across here. push this there, come over here, and you can just push this up there, come up down this way, and there we go. Yeah, not all puzzles require creative use of bubbles, which is pretty nice. Okay, so yeah, I mean, this is, this level barely uses any bubbles. First off, you are, on this ground, you are faster than snakes. Okay, that'll help a little. Ah, shoot! Moved way slightly too fast. Yeah, it's a thing. So, remember that you are faster than snakes. And this guy is trapped, which is nice. Okay. Make sure this guy's above you. There we go. Oh, shoot. I meant to re-establish it, but it was still established. Well. Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes? Oh, come on, you knew that joke was coming. I quite like snakes, actually. I think they're cute. Good. Okay. So. The other thing, of course, that you can do is... Good. Block him in there. Yeah, that's the other thing you can do with snakes. Or with any of these guys. Is that you can, if you have enough time, you can use your ball to block them. Alright. Okay. Now, on this stuff... The rough green stuff, you are only as fast as the snakes. Keep that in mind. So, yeah. Luckily, snakes have no peripheral vision. Okay, now we are half done. Because, yeah. Okay, wait, go out immediately after the snake. Okay, so. Now this is kind of a thing where you're gonna have to, you know, sort of deal with, 1, 2, 3, good. Right, that's just not gonna work, but if you do this, wait for it to pop. Good. Now, push it up, and there we go. Yeah. Yeah, make use of your magic ball to block the snakes. Sounds like something you'd hear from the attract mode of, like, what was that game called? Gauntlet. Save keys to open doors. Oh god, I think I just dated myself, didn't I? 1, 2, probably don't need to do that, but... Push this here. This is not actually quite the end of the thing. I don't know why she's here when there are, like, 1 or 2 more levels in the block. Crap. And I screwed up. This is what happens when you let yourself get distracted. Oh, well. Alright. Alright, so we push it down here. 1, that should be fine. Yep, good. Okay, push it here now. 1, 2, just to be safe. Good. 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 And let's see. What we actually want to do is come up here. 1, 2, 1, push that there, pop. Push that there. Good. Now. Again. Let's see. One should be fine. One. Push it up and over. And there we go. Yeah, I don't know why Juno's here, because there's at least one more and maybe two left in this block, but whatever. Push that up because it's just going to be in our way. Okay, so don't push it to the right because it would fetch up here and you'd be stuck. So you can push it this way. And now remember that you're going to be doing a lot of... Whoa, I did not mean to get hung up there. Right, so you're going to be doing a lot of taking the long way around things, so keep that in mind with whenever you do a bubble. And I would suggest, you know, err on the side of caution time-wise. There we go. Now, this... Okay, no, this isn't the place. It's the next one. There we go. And stage 33. So, yeah. Okay, so we've got a snake here. Let's see here. What we have to do is... There. There we go. Okay, so we want to move this thing. Ah. Actually, what we want to do is this. So wait for the snake. 1, 2, 3, kick. 1, 2, 3, pop. Good. Move it down here. Good. Kick it over here. Now, okay, so kick that there, pop it, move it this way. I screwed up. Yep. Because you will block yourself off from the gate if you're not careful. One kick, 1, 2, 3, pop. Good. Don't need to worry about getting down there in time, so long as we do it this way. Okay, so kick it there. Do not... Okay, so come up this way. And 1, 2, 3. Kick it, 1, 2, 3, pop. Kick it, walk across. Now get up here before it pops. Because, yeah. So that's sneaky. And our next block is the Ice Palace, and we're gonna leave it here. So, thank you guys for joining me for Let's Play Little Magic as we deal with new and interesting mechanics. So, you guys have a great evening, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.